Hello and welcome to our talk, Volkos Efficient Large State Tweakable Block Ciphers from the AES Round Function. As you can see from the title, we build another block cipher, and one of the main questions one has to ask themselves when building a new block cipher is, what do we want to achieve with this new primitive? What do already existing block ciphers not fulfill that we want to achieve? And for us, there were three main goals that we wanted to achieve. In the case that quantum computers become practical and big enough, the exhaustive key search will be much faster, and therefore we need larger keys for the post-quantum era. For example, a 128-bit key could be brute-forced with the work of 2 to the power of 64 instead of 2 to the power of 128. Furthermore, we think that a larger state can benefit modes in a different way than just encrypting more data with one iteration of a block cipher, namely with what we call the bigger birthday bound. A lot of classical modes are only secure up to the so-called birthday bound security. So again, for a 128-bit state size, it would be secure only to up to roughly 2 to the power of 64 blocks. There are some modes that try to achieve beyond birthday bound security, but these usually come at a computational cost. With increasing the state size to 256, 512, or 1024 bits, we can also increase the birthday bound security while keeping the same performance as the classical modes. Furthermore, large or larger tweaks could benefit highly secure and performant modes in classical and post-quantum setting, as well as allowing authentication modes to process more data than just, say, 4-bit tweaks that are usually used only for domain separation. But again, why do we need another block cipher to achieve these three goals? There are already a lot of block ciphers, and we now want to take a look at the most relevant for our cases and see if there isn't already one that solves our problems. The first one would be FreeFish, the block cipher underneath the SHA-3 candidate scheme. It has relatively large state and key sizes. It also has a relatively large tweak size of 128 bits, but it is built upon the operations addition, rotation, and XOR. This allows for similar performance across multiple or very different processor platforms, but is often slower than AES-based constructions if the processors support AES instructions. TRUX is another block cipher built on the ARX principle. Yet, while having state and key sizes of 256 bits, it only claims 128 bits of security. Furthermore, it is intended for 30-bit processors, or at least its implementation was done for a 32-bit processor, which gives worse performance than on a larger processor. Kaluna is the new block cipher standard for the Ukraine. It has state and key sizes between 128 and 512 bits, where the key is either the same as the state size or twice the state size. It has no tweak, but it is based on the AES, which should provide it with really good performance on modern processors. Saturna is also a substitution permutation network that is usually represented in a cubic manner. It has state and key size of 256 bits and a tweak size of 4 bits, which suffices for example, domain separation. Its performance on modern processors should theoretically be somewhere around 3.5 cycles per byte, theoretically, because it was also thought mainly for lightweight processors and not implemented on modern or on more heavyweight processors. 3D is again an AES-based block cipher with 256 and 512 bit state and key sizes. It has, compared to AES, a more heavy or more heavyweight key schedule because they use the MDS from Anubis instead of the metrics used by the AES. This again slows down the key schedule and does not allow us to use the instructions on modern processors that are built for the AES with the AES metrics. Lane is a hash function, which is again AES-based, has no tweak, but relatively large state sizes. ASQ is another hash function, which focuses on 256-bit pre-image security. It is used in the PEEK construction, and again has 512 bits of state, no tweak, and is AES-based with really good performance. And finally, Haruka version 2 has state sizes of 256 and 512 bits. No tweak again, but really good performance by being based on the AES. The main difference between version 2 and version 1 is that version 2 has round constants that were used to thwart attacks that were possible on version 1. The closest primitive presented here to our goals would be Freefish. But since it's based on ARX instead of AES, we think that we can improve its performance, especially on modern processors where its performance should be better than the one presented here. To summarize our goals again, we want to present a family of block ciphers that are highly performant, with state sizes of 256, 512, and 1024 bits. A key size of 256 bits for all state sizes, which should be sufficient for post-quantum security. Furthermore, all state sizes have an instance with a tweak of 128 bits, while we also provide an instance for the 256-bit state size with a 256-bit state. As the core building block for Focus, we chose the AES round function. This has two main reasons. First of all, we expect that processors that are used to handle large state sizes also have special instructions for the AES round functions, giving us an advantage regarding the performance. Secondly, we can rely on decades of research on the AES round function, as well as tools that allow for easier analysis of our cipher. Given that the AES round function works on only 128 bits, we need to split our larger state into multiple 128 substates and think about how to transform and combine them. For this, we decided to use a step-based structure where between each step a permutation mixes with substates. Thus, we have to decide how many rounds of the AES round function we want to use within each step, as well as how different permutations with different word sizes will impact the security and performance of our cipher. Finally, we will have to add a tricky schedule, which will be built on the SDK construction by Jeremy Shaw and their colleagues. As to how many rounds of the AES per step we want to use, Haruka and PyQ have found that 1.5 AES rounds can be viewed as 4 parallel superboxes. Thus, 2 rounds of the AES act as a column-wise MDS matrix. Furthermore, Shiba et al. Have shown that 2 AES rounds provide the fastest diffusions. Thus, using more than 2 rounds per step would not be beneficial for us, while having full diffusion over the substate in each step is desirable. So we followed the example of Haruka and ISQ and chose 2 rounds per step. An additional bonus of the findings of Haruka and PyQ would be that a guaranteed branch number allows us for easier automated analysis of different permutations in our next step. But before we can analyze our permutations, we have to choose their word size. We will discuss how we choose these word sizes for our permutations on the example of our instance with 512 bits of state size. Choosing 64-bit words would mean that we cannot distribute a word from each substate to each other substate, as we would only have two words from each of our four substates. Thus, we would have a much slower diffusion compared to smaller word sizes, where we can distribute a word from each substate to all substates. Choosing a word size of 8 or 16 bits would allow us for optimal diffusion, but we would have to use certain instructions that are less performant than their 32-bit counterparts. Finally, 32-bit words give us an optimal trade-off between performance and diffusion. And as I have mentioned before, 32-bit words would perfectly mirror the MDS property that we achieve by using two rounds per step. Using permutations that preserve the relative positions within substates allow us for using blend instructions that are more performant than combinations of shuffle or unpack instructions. The latter two instructions would be required for permutations that do not preserve the relative positions. With relative positions, we mean that the first word would always go to the first word in its new state. As can be seen on the left, the first word always goes to the first word. The second word always goes to the second word. The third word always goes to the third word. Here. And the fourth always to the fourth. This again allows us to use the blend instruction. If you wanted to use a permutation such as the one in Haka version 2, we would need to move the words in their substates to then get them to another relative position. We can either do this by shuffling and blending or by using the unpack instructions. Both combinations would yield a slower performance or lower performance compared to its blend counterparts. Furthermore, it can be shown that all permutations that preserve the relative positions yield the same lower bound on the number of active S-boxes. So we could simply choose one of the permutations from that subset, and we chose the one you can see here on the left for our 512-bit instance. Having now chosen our permutation and our number of rounds per step, we now only need to add our tree key schedule. For our instances with a state size larger than 256 bits, we first need to enlarge the key to fit the state size. To do so, we multiply the original key with the following circular matrices and use the result as the additional key states. Here, we also show the matrices in the classical representation. Having keys of the equal size to the state, we can now adapt the tree key schedule to our cipher. As an example, we will look at the two instances with state sizes of 256 bits. As you can see, we first add the round constant to the first key substate. This is meant to break up symmetries, and we use the same round constants as Haka version 2, namely the digits of pi. We only need to add it to one substate of the key, because in the following steps and the application to the state and the AES round functions will distribute these differences and breaking symmetries to all other parts of the other substates. After adding the initial round constant, we then add the tweak word to both key states to receive our first round keys that are used for the pre-whitening. Then we apply the same permutation as we do between each step for the plaintext And then we apply a bitwise permutation on the key and the tree. After that, we multiply the key by 2. This is meant so that each tree byte can cancel out each key byte only once within a certain period of rounds that is larger than the total number of rounds in Falcos. After that, we XOR the second round constant into our first key state and then retrieve the next round keys. The instance with a 256-bit tree size works very similar. The main difference is that we now also have to imply the word permutation on the complete tree. This is meant so that each tree cell is always responsible for the same key cell, and therefore cancel it out only once. And of course, we do not add the same tree substate to all key substates, but the first key substate to the first tree substate, and the second tree substate to the first to the second key substate to retrieve our round keys. The tree key schedules for our 512 and 1024-bit instance work similar to the instance of 256-bit state and 128-bit tree. And for time reasons, we cannot show them here, but they are explained in the paper. To show how it all comes together, we will now show the first step of Falcos 512, 256, 128. As explained before, we first expand the key by multiplying it with the first circular matrix to retrieve two more key substates. Then the first round constant is added to the first keyword. And after that, the tweak is combined with all keywords to retrieve the first round keys that are used for a pre-whitening. After that, the first round of AES is applied, although here we use the AES round without key addition, because in this visualization we show the key addition outside of the AES round. Before we add the next round constant, we apply our word and bytewise permutations and multiply our key states by 2. Then we add the next round constant and retrieve our round keys. After applying the second round and the third round keys, we then apply the wordwise permutation also to the plaintext state. We implemented Falcos in C using the Intel intrinsics for certain operations, and the implementation as well as code used for the analysis can be found in our GitLab repo that is mentioned in the paper. Here you can see the performance of Falcos on Intel Skylake, and as you can see, without parallelization, its performance lies somewhere between 1.36 cycles per byte and 1.9. With parallelization, we can reduce its performance to around 1 cycle per byte. Furthermore, both versions with 256 bits of state size need 8 steps, so 16 rounds of AES. The 512-bit version has 10 steps, which would be equal to 20 rounds of AES, and the 1024-bit state size version has 12 steps, which means 24 rounds of AES. We will now shortly summarize our analysis of Falcos. Given that we only use 256-bit keys, the security that we aim for in the standard related tree and related tree key model, of course, is also 256 bits. We used a MILP model and Gorobi to lower bound the number of active S-boxes over a multiple round of steps, and then investigated differential, linear, and integral attacks, including boomerangs and rectangles, impossible differentials and zero correlation attacks, Slide attacks, yo-yo attacks, mixture differentials, as well as Demirci-Seljuk meet-in-the-middle attacks. Finally, we made some rather broad assumptions about the quantum computer-aided attackers. Here, you can see the lower bounds on the number of active S-boxes in the standard model, since we aim for 256 bits of security, the number of active S-boxes needed to achieve this for a straightforward differential or linear attacks would be 43 active S-boxes. We achieve this after either 4 or 3 steps, which gives us a security margin of twice the number of steps needed, or even more. In the related tweak model, the security margin is reduced only a little bit to 5 steps for the 256-bit versions, while it stays the same for the 512 and 1024-bit versions. In the related tricky model, the security margin is reduced a little further, although we have to add that the bounds derived here are rather pessimistic because our hardware could only allow or could only compute the analysis up to 4 steps for the 256-bit tweak variant, which meant that we had to use these results to compute the lower bound that may be somehow possible for an attacker to achieve, which means that we cannot only add a 3 step in the beginning, but also after each 4th step for the 256-bit tweak variant. So we have here a 3 step and here, and after 3 steps for all other instances. So here, here, and here. We claim that this is rather unrealistic, but since our hardware does not suffice to show it, we state these as the bounds, as the lower bounds. Even though, even with these more pessimistic assumptions, Falkos is secure even in the related tree key model. Here we shortly show the results for boomerang attacks as well as integral distinguishers. For boomerang attacks, even in the related tree key model, we can track at most 5 steps out of 8 for the 256-bit version, a tweak version, and even less for the larger versions. For the integral distinguishers, we did not take a look at the number of steps but rounds, which is twice as large as the steps. And as you can see, if we iterate at most 255 bits, we can break at most 7 rounds, which would be 3.5 steps roughly. And even if we iterate all but 1 bits in the largest version, we can only break 11 rounds with integral distinguishers, which would relate to 5.5 to 6 steps out of 12. So again, we have a really high security margin, even in the related tree key setting. As mentioned before, in the scenario of quantum computer-aided attackers, the security for the key search is reduced to 128 bits, and thus we only claim 128-bit security in the post-quantum secret key model. We could not make any reasonable assumptions about the related tweak or related tweak key model in the quantum computer era, so we do not make any claims about these models, but only in the secret key model for post-quantum era. To conclude this talk, we introduced Falkos, a family of tweakable large state block ciphers that provides high security, even under the assumption of quantum computer-aided attackers, allows usage in highly secure modes, including for authenticated encryption, and has competitive performance on a wide range of processors. Thank you for your attention, and if you have questions, we would be glad to answer them after the session.